tired and grumpy. Seems like you've outgrown the Senate. Seems like you're bored with the Senate. We've seen some of those tantrums. Is that boredom? Is that irritation? Are you ready to leave the Senate?
That's nihilism. Is there nothing in life worth living for? Are you going to stand around here and become hypocritical and exhibit your greed in such a public way and don't even have the guts to be ashamed of yourself? That's my way of saying these ideas. For example, people I think now remember me most vividly during the impeachment trial. Mm-hmm. I was a trial judge for 5 years, and some of these guys had never seen a courtroom. They're not familiar with the rules of court, and now they want to do certain things that are unheard of in the judiciary, or they're quoting things out of context because they probably picked out in a summary of quotations. They have no clue what the legal profession is about or what is the meaning of justice. Mm-hmm. That the end product of this entire technical procedure is justice. So, you know, if you're thrown into that kind of a company, you either get cowed into submission like the rest, or you scramble out of the bucket or the pail where you've all been thrown together there. You scramble out there, or you try and explode the bucket, so all of you will get annihilated. Mm-hmm. That the last one, the last alternative, mm-hmm. was my personal choice.
Okay. As a former law professor and as a future judge of the International Criminal Court, that you should presume to administer justice in this manner. I am insulted by the way your minds run. Strike me dead. Eh kung hatulan natin may sala yan, dahil crooked siya, di biglang sabihin tayo, honest tayo. Ngayon, kung lahat pala tayo honest, o marami pala tayo sa atin ay honest, why is the Philippines often, or if not all the time, why is the Philippines always ranked as one of the most corrupt countries in the whole world?
Would you be very surprised if I say that I vote not guilty?
Sifting through all of that, through all of the theatrics and the outbursts, was it really that you believed in Renato Corona's innocence, or were you just rebelling against the absence of logic in the proceedings?
Well, both. I had been RTC judge and had been awarded for my work in the judiciary, so probably it indicates that I know something about the law and what justice means. And, you know, for someone who is completely idiotic in every stem cell of his body, to walk into my courtroom and try to exhibit his as I said, invincible ignorance before me, is for me just an insult. Why are you standing there? Why hasn't God stricken you down yet? So that was my reaction. Plus, you know, you don't have to be perfectly convinced of the innocence of the accused. The rule is you must have reasonable basis to acquit the accused. If there is doubt, acquit. That is the rule.
Have you defined your role in the Senate?
My role is to tell the truth. Mm-hmm. My role is to study the case as much as possible, gather all the information available and accessible to me, and then analyze it as I was taught in law school, because law is nothing but analysis, and apply it to the work of legislation.
So what keeps the truth from coming out? Is it the horse trading? Is it the politics?
Well,
is it the cash in their pockets?
I'm afraid some people run for senator and win because they want to make money out of a senator's position. It's not a unique discovery by any means, but it's very, very chilling when you're already there. Huh? Ganun ba? Kaya pa niyang gawin kaya yon? And then to make all of these self-elevating press releases, we all know that there is a cabal of people who make a living issuing undeserved praises,
so
or trying to destroy other politicians who are the enemies of their patron. It's just organized hypocrisy in many ways. We're all honest people in the Senate, if you listen to every single one of us, right? No one has ever said, I'm a crook and I'm ashamed of it.
Just like the crooks in Muntinlupa, everybody's innocent.
Right, absolutely. And, you know, they deliver these orations about good government. So it's very, very frustrating. I don't think I should ever have entered politics. I don't know how I got in there in the first place. When I was a student, I really viewed it with great horror. Mm-hmm. Enter politics? Huh. What do you think I am?